Lindsey Graham knows the mode that he can shift into that for some reason conservatives like, even though to people like us, it looks like the most fake thing in the world. And that is like his fake anger, like from the Kavanaugh hearing. So here is a little bit, thankfully brief, of Lindsey Graham expressing how mad he is about what's going on at the border.
It is heartbreaking, but this is dumb. This is stupid.
What is your message to President Biden, sir?
Stop it. You don't know what you're talking about.
That should be his message to all of the dopes on the boat that he's traveling around on. But yes, Biden's stupid. He doesn't know what he's talking about. Biden isn't really talking about it, and he isn't really doing anything. He basically, as Anna has laid out, continuing the Trump policy. That's a reason for us to be angry. It's not really a reason for Lindsey Graham to be angry or the conservatives to be angry, except if they feel like, hey, we'd really love the country to be thinking about something other than the stimulus package that the Dems supported that the Republicans didn't. You know, possible follow-up legislation, all these bills. They don't want that. They don't want to be focused on that stuff. And you know, they lost the Seuss thing. People really aren't focused on that. So they need something, and he's providing it. But we also have Ted Cruz, who apparently has been wandering around in the brush for days now. But here's a little bit of Ted Cruz.
Just a few minutes ago, there were multiple smugglers on the other side who were shining flashlights at us, mm-hmm. who were yelling at us, who were taunting us, who were taunting. I think they probably assumed we were Border Patrol, but they routinely taunt the Border Patrol.
They taunted me. They taunted me. But there were smugglers over there with flashlights. Yeah? You're giving a lot of details. What do you know? You know that there were flashlights. That's what you know. You know, I once had to scare a person out of my backyard. That person, Wolverine, I assume, because that makes me look cool. There were people with flashlights. Maybe it was another boat I almost said something bad, of really dumb Republican politicians. I'll say that. Maybe that's what was going on with the flashlights. But guys, they just want to be heroes. And so that's why people like that one congressman, Crenshaw, does the action movie video of him. And Bober is marching around pretending to have a gun in DC. And he's wearing that shiny vest at the border.
What I don't is even know that? Where he. What it's is what, that? Is he wearing a tuxedo vest? Why are you wearing a waiter's vest or a tuxedo vest when you're.
Here's what I'm gonna do. This is my path. I'm gonna take the boat across there and find a nice fancy resort. And I'll be dressed for the occasion.
Ted Cruz, like looking at him gives me a physical reaction. Like it's the Ted Cruz diet plan.
First time anyone's ever said that.
He makes me lose my appetite. Like just looking at him makes me lose my appetite. Like everything about this man. Obviously, it's mostly my feelings are mostly grounded in the fact that he's a despicable human being.
Yes.
But I mean, look, if there is a God, and obviously I'm atheist, so I'm suspicious of that. But if there is a God, man, what did Ted Cruz do in a past life that made God give him a massive L, both physically and internally? Like just L, massive loser. All around.
I think he was a particularly poorly behaved, low moral fiber possum who was reincarnated as a lower being in Ted Cruz. Maybe someday, maybe if he changes his tune, he can come back as some sort of weasel, maybe a stoat. I don't know. But right now,
you're being a little cruel to possums. Like,
yeah, I'm actually a little bit worried. Mary might be watching, and she's very, very into possums. Anyway, okay, I don't want to talk about them anymore because it's just, oh, it's so frustrating. There's an actual crisis on the border. The crisis is a humanitarian crisis. It is not a national security crisis. It's honestly like the pedophilia thing. It's how can we talk so much about this, divorce it of all of the concern for actual people while doing nothing in this area? They did it with supposedly being all worked up about pedophiles and not caring about any of the actual pedophiles. You'll note they're cool with Jim Jordan to this day. And now with the border, let's really talk about it as a crisis, but never show the people and suggest no solutions to the problems that will actually produce less human suffering.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.